Hi everybody. This is Emily, and it's been more than a couple years since I've recorded any podcasts for the Knitting Butterflies podcast. I don't even know if they're called podcasts anymore at this point, but hi. I wanted to say hi and do a little bit of video recording because we're in a pandemic, and something that has really been awesome for me is to keep up with people that I know and care about and watch their beautiful crafting projects that they're making. And so my kids are home. They're in the other room next to me, so they're probably gonna make some noise, but oh well, it is what it is, right? So yeah, I thought I would say hi. I wanted to catch up a little bit and show you some of the stuff that I'm working on. If you are new, maybe because I don't know, I might end up having some new people, but my name is Emily. I live in Colorado, and I used to run a podcast about fiber photography and life. I am not a photographer right now. I am currently in graduate school studying to get my master's in clinical mental health counseling, and so I don't do photography right now because it's too much to do both. This is just going to be kind of a low key. Here's what I've been working on. That's the entire purpose of this because I really like getting inspired by other people's projects and just thought I would share what I'm working on too. So, I used to do a lot of photography tips and things like that. I won't be doing that anymore. I'm not really going to go into a lot of life stuff, even though I think a lot of important things are happening in our country right now and in our world. I'm just not really going to go into that because we do that on social media all the time anyway. If you're interested in hearing what I think about some of these things, you can look up my Instagram. It's butterflyem4. But, I'm just here. So I just wanted to say hi and show you some of the stuff I've been working on, especially since the pandemic has been going. So I am currently obsessed with knitting on U-shift blankets. And I finished one of them that I wanted to show you. It's kind of a mess because we use it all the time now that it's done and it's covered in dog hair. But this is the Hue Shift blanket. This is a Knit Picks pattern that I got for free during a holiday situation or holiday thing that they had. But basically, it's 10 different colors of their Brava Sport. My children are yelling at each other. It's 10 different colors of Brava Sport and each color has an individual square where it's just that color, and then they kind of make a grid where they touch all of the colors twice throughout the blanket. So this is more of the gray and blue side. It's really big, but I love this blanket so much. I got inspired by seeing a lot of them on Instagram and decided I had to knit one. So I went ahead and I would knit one. And the border on this, the original border calls for a garter edge border. And I just chose to do an I-cord border because I was not about to pick up that many stitches and knit around. They're fighting. Oh well. So that was how I decided to wrap that up. I'm really glad I did the border. It gave it a little bit more stability than it had with just being the knitting by itself. So I did that blanket and I wanted to show you that because I'm working on a second one right now. This one is more to match my home decor. We have lots of grays and turquoise and browns and things like that in our house. But I enjoyed knitting one so much that I asked my daughter if she wanted one too. And so I have two of the four what I call quadrants. So this is knit into four squares and then you seam them all together. And so this is one of the quadrants. This is kind of the warm quadrant with the purple and pink and orange and yellow. And then this is the cool quadrant with the blues and greens. I thought about putting the purple at the end and it just kind of looked almost too warm to sit in the cool quadrant. So this purple was originally going to be here. And then I decided it didn't match. I liked it better with the pinks. So I was glad that I did that change. And if you buy this particular kit from Knit Picks, the colors are in a different order in the pattern, but my daughter wanted it to be rainbow. We call it her mermaid blanket. So in this bag. This is one of my fat squirrel bags, favorite bags ever. This is the quadrant I'm working on right now. So I did the warm and the cool, and now I'm doing the quadrants where you see both of them together. So it's coming along really nicely. This is a super easy knit. Each square takes me about an hour, and so it's kind of overwhelming to think that, that first blanket I knit for probably 120 hours to knit that total, because I ripped out a couple rows and then the I-cord border, because there's 100 squares in it. So that was kind of like, holy smokes, I spent a lot of time on that. But it's nice because I know if I want to sit down and watch a show for an hour, I'll probably get a square done. And normally I don't really like mitered squares very much, but this one, everything is different and I always know where I'm going. It makes it easier to just keep going and keep going and keep going. So I don't know. I love this project. I honestly wouldn't mind probably knitting it again. It's super easy to work on during class or Zoom calls or shows or whatever in the car. Like there's enough to keep my brain interested, but it's not too bad. And then just because I think it's fun, there's all the balls wrapped up together. So if you buy the Knit Picks Brava Sport, it's not a very expensive project. It's like less than $30, I think. So very much worth it. I just finished a pair of socks yesterday I wanted to show. These are some Knit Picks Felici socks. I think the color is called Pink Lemonade. I'm not sure. I think that's what it's called, but the colors are straight up a little strange with my ring light, but that's all right. This is Knit Picks Felici yarn, which I did not enjoy the first time I knit it, and then the more I knit with it, the more I really love it. And I've kind of decided to make most of my socks just be inexpensive washable yarn. And the reason for that is because I have a whole drawer full of socks. I want to say this is like my 66th pair of socks or something that I've knit. And I have probably over 40, 45 of them in my sock drawer. And so I like to be able to knit them with inexpensive yarn that is machine washable now, so that if I decide that I don't have room in my drawer, I can just give them away. And so these are going to go to a friend of mine. Yeah, so those are socks for her. Her favorite colors are pink and yellow. So I thought this would be super fitting for her. I thought it was really pretty. It made me like, looks kind of like a sunrise a little bit. So I love those. Those are done. My other knitting project I have going on right now. This one's been in the works for quite a while. I'd say probably since March, somewhere in there. And this is the swallowtail sweater. I don't remember off the top of my head who it's by. This, coming back to this channel, it's going to be a little less formal than it used to be. I don't know the names of the designers. But I can tell you that this yarn is from Suburban Stitcher. Give you up close of it. There's the butterfly. Like I said, it's called the swallowtail sweater. It's a colorwork sweater out of fingering weight yarn. And the yarn is all by Suburban Stitcher. There is this greenish color up here is called River's Edge. The white color is called Sea Smoke, I believe. I don't remember the name of the dark color. It's like her version of navy. And then I just started this turquoisey color at the bottom, and that's called Tuba. So I finished the color work on this last night. That was exciting. And so now I get to just do stockinette for, I think it says like 11 inches from the underarm. So I have another, I don't know, 8 inches of just straight up stockinette I get to do for a while. So I'm excited for that, just to be able to just go now. This one I messed up a couple times, so it was in timeout for a while. And I'd pick it up and then work on it and then put it back in timeout and pick it up and work on it. And I don't know, it was when I'm motivated to work on it, I really work hard on it, and then the other days I just don't. And so this has been kind of a fun project to pick up. I love looking at the inside color work. Not pretty. Butterfly, you can kind of see it. It's all backwards for me. I'm still learning how to use this. So, but yeah, it's a beautiful project. I have to decide when I'm gonna wear it because, as you guys know, butterflies are kind of my favorite thing. Hence knitting butterflies. But I'm not sure how often I'm gonna wear a butterfly on my clothing. It's just not normally my style, but now that I see it on, I kind of like love it. So I'm excited to see how this turns out. And once I added this turquoise last night, I was like, ooh, I might actually be wearing this all the time. So I'm hoping that the size is right. I did not swatch for this. So I actually still don't know what my gauge is. And I'm gonna cross my fingers that it's a big enough gauge to fit me. I'm not going to do the waist shaping on it. I'm to the directions where the waist shaping would start, and I'm not going to be doing that because I've decided that I do not want to have to work to fit into the clothes that I make for myself. And whenever I do waist shaping, I have to work hard to stay small enough to fit into that clothing. Especially because this upper bust measurement for me is usually provides a smaller size than my waist would allow. So if I just leave the waist straight, I'm usually okay. So that's that project. It's going to be a long sleeve sweater. There's more color work on the wrists and on the hem. My husband is installing a door directly above me. So there's a lot going on in our house. Normally, I would not even be recording video with people in the house, but that never ever happens right now. I don't honestly remember the last time I had the house to myself. It's been since COVID that that's happened. So I wanted to show you some spinning projects that I've been doing because that's what has really inspired me is seeing people's hands spun. And after watching Boss and Jen and the Fat Squirrel, I finally got out my wheel again. And the first project that I finished up was this skein. Ooh, I don't know how well it's going to show the colors. That's not too bad. So this is called the Upside Down. The skein is a 3-ply. 100 grams from Into the World. It was a fiber club that I got a while ago. It's purples and some olivey greens and a little bit of gray and a little bit of brown and some light taupey kind of color. It's a 3-ply. I spun it and did a true 3-ply. So I spun it onto three different bobbins and then plied all those together. And then whenever that happens, there's usually a little bit of 2-ply and then a little bit of chain ply at the end. Just so I can use all of the fiber. I don't like having leftovers on my bobbins. So that is that project. I am super excited to have this. I don't know. I'm kind of already making plans. My friend Chana Lines has a cowl that she designed called the Coincide Cowl that I might make this into. That's a really great pattern, or I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I haven't decided yet. It's gonna be something though, and it's gonna be really beautiful. I'm excited for figuring out what to do with my hand spun. I have a whole bunch of hand spun right there and another basket sitting in front of me full of hand spun, but I don't know what I'm going to do with it. So, and then the other hand spun project that I finished up was this one. This is an this was from Greenwood Fiberworks. Has dog hair in it. And this is some BFL, and this was really lovely to spin. I spun this one into a 2-ply. That's about the same weight. I'd say probably like a DK weight. It's a 2-ply. And I spun it as a straight 2-ply, so two different bobbins. And then, of course, when one of them ran out, then I did the rest of it as a chain ply. So there's a little bit of 3-ply in here as well. There it is. You can kind of see like a blip of it like right here. A little bit of chain ply. It's turquoise and it's mostly turquoises and browns. The colorway is called Tribe, which I don't know that I would still call it that. Just try to be sensitive, and appropriate. And so, yeah, it was both of these. I don't really know what else to say other than I spun them. Because it's hand spun, you know, there's not really a lot going into it. I don't usually split my braids. I usually just kind of spin straight off of the braid exactly how it comes, and then let the colors line up however they want to. That's probably how I spin 90% of the time. So that's what I did with both of these. I just spun straight off of the braid as it came, and then let the colors land however it was going to land. But yeah, it's fun having hand spun again. It's fun making yarn again. I forget how much I love it until I pull out my wheel again and start making it. So it got me really, really inspired, and I have a drawer full of fiber. And one of the things I've really been hoarding for a long time is some fiber that I also got from Greenwood Fiber Works. This was at the first Interweave Yarn Fest, so that was, gosh, like 5 years ago at this point. And it's a bunch of yak and silk fiber, and I've spun it came in a package of five kind of mini braids, so I can show you one of them. So it's this big, and it's yak and silk, so it's super soft, and it also makes a really strong strand that's a little bit harder to break, which is nice. So I can spin really, really fine, and I'm not as worried about it breaking. And it's shiny and it's beautiful. So this is the final color, is this turquoise, and it's actually showing up pretty accurately right now. And then I already finished little baby skeins. So I have a dark brown, and then this lighter brown, and then kind of a yellowy green are the ones I have finished. And then on my bobbins right now, I have this kind of bluish green. So you can kind of see the color progression. Let's see if I can hold this up for you. So there's those, and then this one will be the last one. And I actually do have plans for this already. I think I'm going to knit a really open knit, like a really loose gauge scarf that stripes from end to end like this, and then just start with this dark brown color and knit the length that I want it with a, like I said, like a nice loose gauge, as many rows as it will let me knit, and then go to the next brown, and then go to the yellow green, and then the blue green, and then the blue at the end. So you'll be able to see the color progression in the stripes, but it'll also kind of gradiate in between the colors and just knit until I run out of yarn. And so for these, I have a little over 100 yards of each of these, and that's kind of what I'm expecting for this. This dark brown, I might have a little bit less. I wanted to try Andean plying with this, and so I spun the entire braid onto one bobbin, and then I took that bobbin and I wrapped it around my hand in a special way to make a bracelet. And I've only done this twice in my life. I did it with my very first skein of hand spun that I ever spun on a drop spindle, and I felt like my finger was going to fall off because it was so tight, and my finger turned really dark purple, and I was like fighting to get it off. And that same thing happened with this, and this yarn does not have a lot of stretch to it because of the silk, and so that was a little harrowing. And then it really got tangled up really, really badly, and so I don't know if my twist was too tight for an Andean ply or what the deal was, but I lost 5 to 10% of the skein from just tangled messes that I could not get out, and I gave up. So I might have a little bit less on here, and so I learned my lesson, and with this one I stuck to the half a braid on each bobbin and then did the 2 ply. And that I found actually provided a much closer estimate to being able to do the 2 ply. I wanted to do the Andean braid with this because I didn't want to waste any of the fiber, and there is some waste when I'm doing the 2 ply on these, but there's not a ton. It makes like a little ball about this big, so it's not very much at all that I'm losing. So I did that with both of these, and then this is the first half of that fiber, and then I have the second half on my wheel right now, and I'll do this one. So I actually think that is it for the projects that I'm working on right now. So like I said, I'm not going to be doing this nearly as formally as I used to be doing. There's no show notes. There's no Ravelry page. I think I actually got rid of the Knitting Butterflies Ravelry page, but Yeah, I'm just here to say hi and share what I'm working on because I know it inspires me to watch what all of you are working on. If you want to connect with me, you can find me on Instagram as ButterflyEM4, or feel free to comment below. And that's kind of it. So I hope you all have a wonderful weekend, and I'll talk to you soon.